search and rescue missions, and for that they can launch at 30 minutes notice. The crew tell me that they're also equipped these helicopters with an obstacle warning system, which only Finland and Germany have on their NH90s. Very useful for the sort of low-level special operations flying.
Ladies and gentlemen, Queen, White, and Red of the Italian flag.
Major, VHA to start with shine in the black field of the flight test department image. Three to records set by our pilots across the history. Three names, three records still unbeaten. History of achievements. The flight test department has made its challenge and projection towards the future. Its reason for life. 1930 flight record in a closed circuit. 67 hours. 1934 speed record for a seaplane with piston engine. 709 kilometers. Landing in C-27J, Spartan stops in less than 300... Back in the air again! C-27J, Spartan crew.
Chosen was developed by Frank Halford, who was then de Havilland's main engine man. It was the Halford H1 initially, it later became known as the de Havilland Goblin, produced. And its construction is also very interesting. De Havilland, of course, had a great deal of experience building wooden aeroplanes. And when they were there, number 54 Squadron's Vampires thrilled spectators at air shows around the United States and Canada, because 54 had formed the RAF's first ever jet aircraft aerobatic team. And the Vampire was a beautiful aeroplane for that sort of work. Very, very sweet handling. Bit lacking. And so, to describe what promises to be a magnificent display,
wake-off, ready to engage their Spitfire synchro display.
You're standing in a British second-line trench somewhere in the Somme sector of northern France, looking eastwards towards the British front line and towards the German trenches. Aircraft factory B2C, pursued by one of the most feared German fighters of the war, the Fokker triplane, the Fokker DR1, the Dreidecker. B2C. One of the most significant types of the First World War, for Blériot Experimental. It was designed by Geoffrey de Havilland, first built by the Royal Aircraft Factory in 1912. Early tests of BE-2s over Salisbury Plain pioneered the airborne correction of artillery fire. And BE-2A and B models were among the first Royal Flying types. And the poor old BE undergoing the attentions of the far more agile Fokker triplane. BE-2's performance was much criticised, especially its poor manoeuvrability, though that did help make it a stable reconnaissance platform. Sadly, the improved BE-2E was little better. We've got a reproduction of one of those in the static park here. There were still BE-2Cs in RAF service after the armistice, by the time of the armistice on November 11th, 1918. And it's diving in here with one of the SE-5As on its tail. All the while, we remember those who fought, whether in the air, at sea, or on the ground. Ha ha ha! Flying today, we had Dave Linney, Trevor Bailey, and Emily Collett in the SE5As, Matthew Boddington in the BE2C, Mike Collett in the CL1, and Alex Truman and Peter Bond in the Fokker triplanes. Our thanks to them, the members of the 2018 Bremont Great War Display Team.
Change information. So actually what you see right now, ladies and gentlemen, are Swiss pilots in the Swiss-made aircraft presenting you the Swiss Cross with Swiss precision. Not sure if we can get even more Swissness today. So let's go for the passing in the Swiss Cross.
In the captain's seat, Tony Flynn. In the co-pilot seat, John Taylor. Coming in the... Despite the aircraft coming to a halt there about a third of the way down the runway, what you need to remember is it landed 2,000 feet in. To try and keep that short field demonstration as close to the centre of the airfield as possible. The aircraft coming to a halt and starting to reverse in less than 1,500 feet of runway. And the rear ramp down as it passes by. And of course you can get up close to two examples of the Atlas C1.
Aboard Whispers Red 9 as the red and blue smoke comes on, 8 and 9 rolling around the white smoke of the rest of the formation. Red 1 about to bend the formation to the left with a change in colour. Keep those cameras rolling for Tornado. Calls Red 1 as the 7 jets pull up to the vertical. Red 6 and 7 staying low. Red and blue smokes on for the centenary split. As the 7 jets form the palm, keep your eyes on Red 6 and 7 with the white smoke trailing as they move off to the left and right.
Blade 227, B1 Air. Airborne, its display weight is 45,000 pounds, and with over 50,000 pounds of thrust available to this aircraft, this is going to be a really awe-inspiring display.